because this is like the last of it, I had to change the last one because I didn't have enough of the dark ones to do it. So I'm going to try it again in this one. I've got enough of these ones to do it. The rest of the other stuff's going up the sandbows. So we're just going to go through these as a talk through one. And just have a chat. Right, so the next one, we'll take that hot, that hit there. Hollyboards, as we well know, are good for this one now, aren't they? So that's one you probably, you know, I use the other ones because I quite enjoy using them, but you know, not everyone's nutty like me. So your hollyboard is your sort of like your safety net. But just to have like 3 inches now, like for this one, we can do it with the hollyboards. You know, or if you wanted to go at it from a 45, you have to rough in a bit more. Now, just show you how the boards work. See, there's a bit of difference there, so maybe my 45 is off, or it's just a pencil mark, but we'll do it with the pencil's better. So but if you've got a V there and if you're 45 out or it's on a piss and that, you might as well use the hollyboard, you know. We've got the new hollyboard helpers. I just haven't got around to sorting out the dimensions for ordering them yet. I don't know how this has come on. I don't like gerandering. I'm sort of like consciously trying to not make a mess because I'm doing another video just of the whole lot that I'll have on one of my speed ones and that, a bit of music. So I just want to have a chat with you guys. Look at that, fucking beautiful. We're going to do a little custom one on this, just with what I've got here, so which is not a lot, so I'll have a little figure out about what I'm going to do in the middle, so we'll just have a little play this one, and just like talk to you about what you've got to look out for, what you ain't got to look out for when it comes to doing custom work, because truth is, there's no rules to it, is there really? I mean, whatever job you're going to go and do, depending on it, if you're going to try it yourself, if you want to do it, don't look at the videos or the pictures and that lot and think, oh, I want to go and do it, you know, it's like a really nice experience or something, because it is hard on that lot, and you're going to find your first ones you're going to want to do for other people you know, or because you can't expect to go and work for a shop on that lot. If they put a price on the job and you want to take fucking 30 days on the job to doing it, they're not going to pay you, are they? So try to keep your custom work, you know, you can go, as more experience you get, you know, like making your own, but I'm telling you now, it's a lot more difficult to do a, like a pattern floor, herringbone, box weave, or any of those ones than it is to do any custom floor. So, concentrate on that first. But anyway. This one here. You'd have different choices, wouldn't it? I mean, you suppose you could try to get it from there, but you'd have to have... That one might be the pain. So we're just going to go at it with the standard board. down, 45 template. Tabs on the back of these colours. Oops, I missed that one out. Actually, I won't use the magnet, but let's use a but it is important that you do get your your best to get your field on the 45. Like I've reset mine out on this one, but I took a bit of time on it. I've made the area slightly smaller just so I can use the rest of the garage for other stuff, and you know, the plan is to get back into exercising. Fuck if I have fun. So that was just your standard board and the 45 template, wasn't it? These ones are always more difficult if something is off. I mean, I can assure you all of this area here. Okay, where have I lost my knife? It's not all perfectly square here, so you are going to get those ones, but you've just got to do that to it. But it's better that than it being too short and it's horrible, or you just got, you know what I mean, hooked it in or something. So, again, as soon as you get your V out, you know that you're good, and you know Holly's going to just smash it. To be honest, I wish I called this one the chewy board, to be honest with you, because it's the best one out of the lot, really, isn't it? Especially with the old, where are they? These little hollyboard helpers have, they're just great. I mean, I want to see if I can sort out a way of something like getting you guys just to make them yourselves or something. Well, it's a bit tight on there. But they do make a difference when you want to cut in, because you can really pull back on it then without worrying about the tile moving. It does pay off, you know, because I reckon she's good on the old 45, this one. Like, even if it goes out a little tiny bit, it's not undoable, but it's, you know what it's like, it's a ball like, isn't it? So, these are the cuts why little 45 ball comes in handy. But, like I said, it's how often do you get these jobs, you know, these ones. On the 45, but these ones do come in handy, otherwise you have got to kind of drop it back to here and then, you know, load the tiles up a little bit. But at least this way, you know, the 45 does get in these little ones and you can do your cuts. So, what's this one going to be? Well, you can either follow the route, can you? Put a little piece in there and do it in two bits, or you can just bang it in there in one if it's right up to the corner and it's going towards the end. So we'll do the double whammy. Now this is one that's It's good when you first do it. Sounds a triple whipple, but so if you're going to put a double whammy in, I'll try to get it roughed down so you can still bat it off the tank so you can pull it. So it really is important to try and keep the tile in one place when you're doing a double whammy. But anyway, so you've got it there. Twice because a little bit on the chilly side, that ground level. So, and I've snapped this yet. That's better. Bloopers, haven't it? So let's see what we've done here. Cool. I don't know how I've managed to do that, but can you see that? That's like... I fucking got no idea what I've done there, but... I've nosed it right up, but we'll do that again, shall we? I'll edit it. I was trying to think if it was anything to do with lining up, but it's not, is it? Because you're going all the way across, so... And there's just literally just that little kink out of the wood is there. Come on, let's take it back. a bit of a dishes under them, really. Let's just loosen her up a bit. If you've got a dishes under it, they honestly, they just tap in home and fine, but if you ain't got nothing holding them underneath them, if you're going wet set, you know, make sure you go back and give it a good roll.